state-of-the-art tunnel that has been built by IFLS and the National Highway Authority of India. The Prime Minister arriving at the tunnel. This is the Chenani entrance of the tunnel. Along with the Prime Minister, Union Minister Nitin Gadkari. Union Minister of State in the Prime Minister's office, Dr. Jitendra Singh, Chief Minister of Jammu and Kashmir, Mehbooba Mufti, the Governor, N.N. Vora. The Prime Minister unveiling the plaque and formally inaugurating and dedicating to the nation the Chenani-Nashri Tunnel, a 9.2-kilometer engineering marvel, state-of-the-art tunnel, which will not only cut down travel time and reduce distance physically, but also will be a major step in integrating the Kashmir Valley with the rest of the state and increasing connectivity and, by a spin-off, development. The Prime Minister right now sitting for a group photograph with all the engineers of the company that actually executed this project. It is a great technological marvel. They've cut through a mountain, a 19 kilometer long passage. There are two tunnels. 9.2 is the main kilometers, is the main tunnel. There is a parallel evacuation tunnel, so that takes it to about 18.4. There are 29 cross passages connecting the two tunnels, the main tunnel with the evacuation tunnel. So they've actually cut the mountain by about 19 kilometers in just 4 years. The Prime Minister now proceeding to take a first-hand account of the tunnel. He shall be travelling throughout the tunnel and looking at the various systems put in place, be it the firefighting systems, be it the traffic control systems, be it the lighting, be it the electrical systems, the ventilation systems, the communication systems inside the tunnel, the facilities being provided inside the tunnel for commuters. Prime Minister Narendra Modi, Jammu and Kashmir Governor N.N. Vora, Chief Minister Mehbooba Mufti on a mounted vehicle are actually right now going inside the tunnels. These lights that you see, this is the Chenani entrance. About 6,000 LED lights will be lighting the tunnel. Now the Prime Minister, along with the Jammu and Kashmir Governor and the Chief Minister, reviewing the tunnel. You can see the lighting of the tunnel. These systems have been put in place. Those fans are part of controlling the air in the tunnel. In fact, different colored lights like red lights, white lights, green light, orange light have been introduced to break monotony. What happens when, say, a driver enters the tunnel, you can see these green lights along with it, the white lights, the different colored lights to break the monotony of the driving experience. And if somebody experiences phobia, to sort of take their attention away and divert their attention, these lights have been introduced so that traversing through the tunnel could be a safe journey. This tunnel has a gradient. That means that during at the middle of the tunnel goes up by 0.5 gradient, comes down towards the Nashri side by 1% gradient. All along, SOS boxes, CCTV cameras at every 75 meters, air monitoring systems, CO, carbon dioxide and carbon monoxide sensors, opacity sensors, linear heat detectors. If the part of a tunnel is heating up, the detectors can feel the heat. Heat and smoke detectors fitted along, and a state-of-the-art technology is fitted in this tunnel, where in that particular tunnel, say the part of the tunnel that you're right now seeing, if a vehicle breaks down here and there is fire, smoke dampeners, heat dampeners will come into effect in that particular section of the tunnel. Traffic will only be stopped a little ahead of that section of the tunnel, so that that part can be isolated, and fire tenders in the evacuation tunnel, which runs parallel to the main tunnel, will arrive along with the fire tending bikes and use various latest technologies of, say, the foam method to put out that fire. There is a elaborate communication system inside the tunnel. Of course, the VHF radio works here. In fact, 92.7 radio, FM radio broadcasting is does also. This is the control panel that you see on your screens. These you can see the vehicles actually being monitored. There are people sitting here. It's an automated system which can detect that an accident has happened, say, in a particular part of the tunnel, or the air quality in a particular part of the tunnel has gone down. The ventilation then system will then start pumping fresh, more fresh air there, or start using the exhaust to throw out the carbon dioxide or the carbon monoxide, the toxic air smoke that may have accumulated there. This is the control room from where this whole integrated control system is operated. It's automated. A lot of functions of these are automated. The idea behind it is to reduce human intervention, and thereby the scope of human error. There is an FM radio broadcasting, 92.7 FM will work in the tunnel. The control mechanism is so designed that it can be taken over at any time by the traffic management here, and if an important announcement has to be made, it can be made over the FM radio by actually stopping the broadcast. Your phones will work, GSM phones will work inside the tunnel. There is, of course, executive broadcasting. That means that if you wish to, what you're seeing on your screens right now is a telephone box. If there is a case of emergency or a breakdown, commuters can get off and make a call, and the assistance will arrive, which in any case is being monitored in the control room that you see on your screens right now. An integrated control room, which is automated, is completely run by control systems, but if human intervention is required, SOS boxes have been fitted, telephone equipment have been fitted. In any case, the telephone, the GSM SIMs, your mobile phones work inside the tunnel. There is a SOS box at every 150 meters on both sides of the tunnel. It's a bi-directional tunnel. That means one lane of outgoing traffic, one lane of incoming traffic. 118 SOS boxes on both sides. There are CCTV cameras with aid at every 75 meters. So every movement of every vehicle is being tracked on the control system, the fully integrated tunnel controlling system. There is a carbon dioxide and carbon monoxide and opacity sensor at every 1200 meters, essentially to monitor air quality. If the air quality has reduced, there is a ventilation system which will pump in fresh air and pump out the stale air from that particular section. The ventilation system, the transverse ventilation system, which is being used for the first time in the complete tunnel in India, is in any case running around the clock in the tunnel. the Prime Minister himself reviewing the various features of this tunnel and taking a tour of the tunnel. Oh, we can see the Prime Minister has stopped his vehicle. He's alighting from the vehicle. Technical experts are greeting him. The Prime Minister getting down to the vehicle, from his vehicle, taking a walk and looking at the various features of the tunnel. We can see the tunnel management and the construction committee, construction companies, technical people explaining. The Prime Minister at the SOS box opening, getting inside the SOS box and trying to understand the various features of this there. The Prime Minister being briefed by the technical experts of the various facilities that this SOS box provides. As I was saying, there are such boxes at every 150 meters, a total of 118 such boxes in the whole 9.2 kilometer long tunnel. We can see the Prime Minister accompanied by the Governor and the Union Transport and Highways Minister Nitin Gadkari. Also, Chief Minister Mehbooba Mufti. Technical experts of the construction and management company explaining to the Prime Minister the various features. The Prime Minister actually getting down from his vehicle and taking the Prime Minister now has come through the cross passage into what is the evacuation tunnel. This is a 9.2 kilometer long tunnel, a parallel tunnel which runs parallel to the main tunnel. In the event of a fire or event of a disaster, people can be brought into this tunnel through the cross passages. There are 29 such cross passages and can be evacuated safely through this tunnel, this evacuation tunnel. Such passages essentially for connecting the main tunnel to the evacuation tunnel. The evacuation tunnel also serves another purpose. In the event of a fire, it can pump in air to control the fire right up to the main tunnel so that it does not get into the evacuation tunnel and people can be brought out safely. The Prime Minister actually walking in the tunnel, taking a review of the various features. The Prime Minister waving. It's being beamed live on television screens across India. The Prime Minister of India actually dedicating the tunnel, walking and taking a walk in this tunnel. Two lanes of the tunnel, one for the traffic coming from Srinagar to Jammu, and the traffic the other for the Srinagar bound traffic from Jammu. So the Prime Minister going through the whole 9.2 kilometer length of this bi-directional tunnel, which has a single lane for each direction. This is the control room, which is the completely integrated control room of the tunnel, which controls various functions of traffic management, safety management, communications of this tunnel, the great lighting of the tunnel. As I was earlier saying, there are signages at every 100 meters in the tunnel. There are some do's and don'ts and traffic safety rules which have to be followed inside this tunnel. The do's for the tunnel users: remove sunglasses, switch off headlights, turn on dipped headlights, follow the directions displayed on the signage, and watch out for any changes in the speed limit. The speed limit for this tunnel has been set at 50 kilometers per hour. At normal smooth flowing traffic, it should take about 12 minutes to 15 minutes to cross this tunnel from one end to the other. Commuters are advised to follow the speed limit. Even in case of stoppage of a vehicle, they are advised to maintain distance with the immediate ahead vehicle, a minimum of 3 meters of distance, so that collisions can be avoided. Users perforce have to switch on to FM frequency 92.7 when entering the tunnel. This is essentially not just for entertainment. Of course, 92.7 will provide you entertainment, but this channel will also be used to relay information of the tunnel conditions and relay information in case of any emergency. The control room that you see on your screens right now will take over that frequency and relay information. They can actually see these 118 CCTV cameras along the whole tunnel will be providing actually real-time information for the tunnel. So these are visuals, live visuals that we are beaming to you from inside the Chenani-Nashri Tunnel. It's a 9.2 kilometer long two-lane tunnel, 13 meters of diameter, and it has a parallel escape tunnel or an evacuation tunnel, which is of course a little smaller because it's single lane. It has a 6 meters diameter, which is connected, interconnected. The two tunnels are interconnected at 29 cross passages, which are at an interval of 300 meters. So you are visuals dekh rahe hain Chenani-Nashri Tunnel ke andar se is waqt jahan Pradhan Mantri Narendra Modi is tunnel mein is surang ka muayana kar rahe hain. Unhone kuch der pehle is tunnel ko inaugurate kiya, dedicate kiya Jammu and Kashmir ke logon ko aur Bharat ke logon ko. Is tunnel ko throw open kiya jayega traffic ke liye, arm commuters, arm users is tunnel ko kal subah 7:30 baje se use kar sakte hain. Tamam vehicles, chahe wo LMV vehicles ho, light motor vehicles ho ya heavy trucks ho, wo ek toll pay karke is road ko use kar sakte, is tunnel surang ko use kar sakte hain, jo Nashari jo ke Ramban zile Jammu Kashmir ke Ramban zile ko Chenani jo ke gaon hai Udhampur zile se connect karegi. Keval pura pehle ye 41 kilometer lamba rasta hua karta tha, ab ye keval 9.2 kilometer reh jayega, to kareeb 30 kilometer ka rasta cut kiya gaya, cut ho jayega, ye distance cut ho jayega, jiska travel time mein matlab ye hai ke 2 se 2.5 ghante ki bachat. ईंधन के हिसाब से 27 लाख रुपए प्रतिदिन की ईंधन बचत होगी जो एग्जिस्टिंग ट्रैफिक है उस पर. अगर ट्रैफिक बढ़ता है ऑफ कोर्स ये ज़्यादा बचत होगी. ये ऑल वेदर टनल है. अक्सर देखा जाता था कि नेशनल हाईवे 44 पर क्योंकि ये पूरा एरिया लैंडस्लाइड प्रोन एरिया है, यहाँ पर लैंडस्लाइड्स हो जाया करती थी, या क्योंकि सिर्फ टू लेन था तो एक्सीडेंट होने के जब एक्सीडेंट होता था या कोई ट्रक ओवरटर्न कर जाता था तो ट्रैफिक रुक जाता था, लंबे लंबे जैम्स लगते थे. इस इंटीग्रेटेड कंट्रोल्ड फुली ऑटोमेटेड टनल के अंदर से के जाने से ऑफ कोर्स ट्रैफिक स्मूथ होगा और वो जो दिक्कतें हैं जो कम्यूटर्स को, उनसे उन परेशानियों से कम्यूटर्स बच पाएंगे. अपने उस विजुअल अपनी स्क्रीन्स पर आप यहाँ के कंट्रोल रूम को देख रहे हैं जहाँ से ये इस टनल के तमाम जो सेफ्टी और कम्युनिकेशंस के सिस्टम्स हैं वो कंट्रोल होते हैं, फायर फाइटिंग सिस्टम्स कंट्रोल होते हैं इस टनल के अंदर से। हर 75 मीटर पर इस टनल में सीसीटीवीज लगे हुए हैं जिनकी फुटेज, जिनके विजुअल्स लाइव इस आप देख सकते हैं इस वक्त अपनी स्क्रीन्स पर, वो बीम होते रहते हैं कंट्रोल रूम में। हालांकि सिस्टम बहुत सारी चीज़ों को टेक ओवर कर लेता है, वो डिज़ाइन ऐसे किया गया है कि वो ऑटोमेटेड सिस्टम रहे, चाहे फायर फाइटिंग की बात हो, चाहे इवैक्यूएशन की बात हो, चाहे वेंटिलेशन सिस्टम की बात हो, फ्रेश एयर को उसमें पंप इन करना जो ट्रांसवर्स वेंटिलेशन सिस्टम के थ्रू, या स्टेल एयर को बाहर एग्जॉस्ट के थ्रू फेंकना, ज़्यादातर ये ऑटोमेटेड फंक्शंस हैं। इसका असेंशली रीज़न ये है कि ह्यूमन इंटरवेंशन को जितना कम किया जा सके, ताकि जो स्कोप का जो एरर है उसको कम किया जा सके। बड़े बड़े चार एग्जॉस्ट फैंस दोनों तरफ लगे हुए हैं जिनकी कैपेसिटी 7,20,000 क्यूबिक मीटर पर आर्ज है। इसका मतलब यह है कि वो लगातार स्टील एयर जो है उसको बाहर निकालते रहेंगे। ऐसे ही चार सप्लाई एयर फैंस लगे हुए हैं जिनका काम है फ्रेश एयर को इस टनल में डालते के में पंप इन करते रहना, ताकि जो एयर की क्वालिटी है, जो लोग इस जब 9.2 किलोमीटर लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस ट्रैवल करेंगे तो वो जो सांस लें वो फ्रेश एयर की सांस हो। इस आप देख सकते हैं तमाम तरह की लाइटिंग यूज़ की गई है, करीब 6,000 एलईडी लाइट्स अलग अलग रंगों की, हरे रंग की, लाल रंग की। इसका असेंशली मतलब ये है, एक तो लाइट अप करना टनल को, तरह जो प्रॉपर रोशनी हो। दूसरी के जब ड्राइवर टनल के अंदर होता है तो अक्सर एक फोबिया हो जाता है, क्लॉस्ट्रोफोबिक हो जाता है, क्योंकि ये बंद टनल है और करीब 12 से 15 मिनट इस टनल में बिताना, तो कुछ ड्राइवर्स को एक फोबिया हो जाता है। उनकी मोनोटनी ब्रेक करने के लिए अलग अलग तरह की लाइटिंग्स हैं, ताकि वो डिस्ट्रैक्टेड रहें और किसी फोबिया में ना रहें और ट्रैफिक स्मूथली पास होता रहे, एक्सीडेंट के चांसेस को कम किया जा सके। करीब 720 बल्ब हैं जो 150 वाट नाइट टाइम बल्ब्स हैं, 1250 साइड वॉक्स पर बल्ब्स लगाए हुए हैं, 720 केयर स्टोन लाइट, 2 वॉट्स की छोटी छोटी लाइट्स अलोंग लगाई हुई हैं, रिफ्लेक्टर्स हैं। ये पूरे हम देख सकते हैं कि इस वक्त प्रधानमंत्री का कैवलकेड पूरी टनल का मुआयना कर रहा है। उनके साथ चीफ मिनिस्टर महबूबा मुफ्ती और जम्मू एंड कश्मीर के गवर्नर एनएन वोरा उनके साथ हैं, यूनियन मिनिस्टर नितिन गडकरी और भी प्रधानमंत्री के साथ इस टनल का मुआयना कर रहे हैं इस वक्त। ये अपने आप में एक बड़ा इंजीनियरिंग का एक बड़ा नमूना है, क्योंकि ये टनल, क्योंकि इसमें बहुत सा, ये एक तो साउथ एशिया की पहली इतनी लंबी टनल है, जिसमें मैंने जैसे कहा कि 2 लेन की ये टनल है, जो मेन टनल है उसके बगल में एक पैरेलल एस्केप टनल जो करीब 6 मीटर्स डायमीटर की है। इन दोनों वो एसेंशली एक इवैक्यूएशन टनल है, अगर कोई आपदा होती है, फायर होती है, आग लग जाती है, या कोई सिक्योरिटी इंसिडेंट होता है या और किन्हीं वजहों से लोगों को वहाँ से इवैक्यूएट करना पड़े, तो ये 29 ऐसे पैसेजेस हैं दोनों ही टनल्स के बीच में से, जिसको तुरंत लोगों को इवैक्यूएट किया जा सके। इस मेन टनल पर जहां प्रधानमंत्री इस वक्त मुआयना कर रहे हैं, ये ट्रैफिक के लिए यूज़ किया जाएगा। जो इवैक्यूएशन टनल है वो एसेंशली स्टैंड बाय टनल है। ये आप देख सकते हैं बड़े बड़े पंखे लगे हुए हैं टनल की एंट्रेंस पर, जो एसेंशली एयर क्वालिटी को रेगुलेट करते हैं। ये टनल की छत पर एग्जॉस्ट और फ्रेश एयर पंप इन करने के डक्ट्स हैं, और ये पूरी छत के ऊपर ऐसे एक पूरा ट्रांसवर्स वेंटिलेशन सिस्टम है जो स्टेल एयर को उसको सक आउट कर रहा है और बाहर फेंक रहा है चिमनीज के थ्रू. अगर आग लगती है स्मोक के लिए स्मोक डैम्पनर्स हैं, उनको पुल आउट करने के लिए एग्जॉस्ट फैंस हैं. चार बड़े बड़े फैंस दोनों ही कोनों पे, दोनों ही एंड्स पे लगाए गए हैं. इस वक्त हम देख रहे हैं कि प्रधानमंत्री टनल का मुआयना कर कर टनल के बाहर इस वक्त आ गए हैं. प्रधानमंत्री के साथ गवर्नर, जम्मू एंड कश्मीर के गवर्नर एनएन वोरा और मुख्यमंत्री महबूबा मुफ्ती, उन्हीं की गाड़ी पे मुआयना करके इस टनल का आए हैं. वेल द प्राइम मिनिस्टर हैज नाउ गॉन बैक. ये चेनानी एंड से आए थे और ये नाशरी एंड है जो रामबन डिस्ट्रिक्ट में है. क्लियरली प्रधानमंत्री ने 9.2 किलोमीटर का पूरा दौरा किया और मुआयना किया इस टनल का. और प्रधानमंत्री अब नाशरी एंड से यू टर्न लेकर अब दूसरी ओर से बाहर जा रहे हैं. आप दो लेन्स देख सकते हैं, एक लेन पर प्रधानमंत्री का कैवलकेड आया, दूसरी लेन से प्रधानमंत्री जा रहे हैं अपने गाड़ी पर जा रहे हैं. इसी तरह ये दो लेन्स में ट्रैफिक चला करेगा. एक जो जम्मू बाउंड ट्रैफिक होगा वो एक लेन में चलेगा, जो श्रीनगर बाउंड ट्रैफिक होगा वो दूसरी लेन में चलेगा. आम जनता के लिए, कम्यूटर्स के यूज़ के लिए आज जब प्रधानमंत्री इसको डेडिकेट कर चुके हैं, इनॉग्रेट कर चुके हैं, ये आम लोगों के यूज़ के लिए कल सुबह 7:30 बजे से खोल दी जाएगी. ये एक टोल कंट्रोल्ड टनल है. इसका मतलब ये है कि तमाम व्हीकल्स को इसको यूज़ करने के लिए टोल देना पड़ेगा. टोल गेट्स टनल की दोनों साइड की एंट्रेंसेस पर लगे हुए हैं और वहाँ इनफैक्ट कुछ हीट सेंसर्स लगे हैं. मान लीजिए एक गाड़ी का टेम्परेचर ज़रूरत से ज़्यादा है, उसको सिस्टम अपने आप परमिट नहीं करेगा अंदर जाने के लिए, उसको वहाँ पर साइड वे में कूल ऑफ करना पड़ेगा इससे पहले कि उसको एंट्री मिल पाए. इस वक्त हम देख सकते हैं प्रधानमंत्री राज्यपाल एन एन वोरा के साथ और मुख्यमंत्री महबूबा मुफ्ती के साथ का टनल का मुआयना करते हुए. ये कंट्रोल रूम सिस्टम है जहां से प्राइम मिनिस्टर कहां से इस वक्त प्रधानमंत्री कहां से पास कर रहे हैं, ये हर चप्पे चप्पे की जो रियल टाइम इंफॉर्मेशन है इस कंट्रोल रूम में अवेलेबल है. ये कैमरास चेंज हुए जैसे जैसे प्रधानमंत्री आगे जा रहे हैं. हर 75 मीटर पर इस छत पर जो आप देख रहे हैं यहाँ पर ये सीसीटीवी कैमरास लगे हुए हैं जो रियल टाइम इंफॉर्मेशन एसेंशियली कंट्रोल रूम को बाहर थ्रो कर रहे हैं. तो कंट्रोल रूम उसको कंट्रोल रूम में सिस्टम्स जो लगे हुए हैं, फुली इंटीग्रेटेड कंट्रोल सिस्टम, वो उसको ऑटोमेटेड मोड में उसको ऑटोमेट कर रहा है. चाहे वो ट्रैफिक मैनेजमेंट के लिहाज से हो, चाहे वो सेफ्टी के लिहाज से हो, चाहे वो वेंटिलेशन सिस्टम के लिहाज से हो, चाहे वो लाइटिंग के लिहाज से हो, चाहे इलेक्ट्रिकल सिस्टम्स के लिहाज से हो, ये जो इंटीग्रेटेड टनल कंट्रोलिंग सिस्टम है, कम्युनिकेशन सिस्टम्स जो अवेलेबल हैं ये ऑटोमेटेड हैं ताकि ह्यूमन इंटरवेंशन की कम से कम ज़रूरत पड़ सके. So the Prime Minister right now, along with the Governor of Jammu and Kashmir and the Chief Minister of the state inside the tunnel, he entered from the Chenani end, traveled the whole 9.2 kilometer distance, got off, tried to understand, went inside a SOS box. In fact, he went from the cross passage right into the escape tunnel. The technical expertise of the company, the managing company, trying to explain to the Prime Minister the various features of this state-of-art tunnel which the Prime Minister dedicated to the nation today. Now the Prime Minister went right up to the Nashri point, from where he went out, got out of the tunnel, took a U-turn and is now currently on his way back to the other end from where he started. That's the Chenani end, which lies in the Udhampur district. Also present here is Dr. Jitendra Singh, the Minister of State in the Prime Minister's office, who is also a member of parliament from Udhampur. So it's really his constituency in which this tunnel, one end of this tunnel lies, and the Prime Minister today inaugurating it. This tunnel is a state-of-the-art tunnel which was completed in merely 4 years, and that is quite an engineering marvel. It is an all-weather tunnel, completely rainproof, waterproof tunnel. In fact, there is no tunnel as of now in India which is completely waterproof. I was speaking to the project director of this tunnel in the morning. He was telling me the various technologies used in this tunnel have been used for the first time. In fact, it is the world's first fully integrated tunnel. It is a fully integrated tunnel controlling system. That means various aspects that I spoke about, the safety aspect, the traffic management aspect, the lighting aspect, the communication systems aspect, the ventilation aspect, are automated under one control structure. That he says, he told me that nowhere in the world has that been used. So in that sense, it is the technologies used have set many firsts. Apart from that, cutting a huge mountain is a challenge in itself. They've cut the mountain for 19 kilometers, 9.2 one tunnel, add another 9.2 with the parallel escape tunnel, 18.4, add 29 connecting passages, cutting a mountain into 19 kilometers of length. That is an engineering marvel. The gradient, you know, the maximum point of the mountain, the height of the mountain above the tunnel is 1 kilometer, 1,000 meters. That means there is 1 kilometer of mountain above this tunnel. So one can well understand the kind of pressure that this tunnel is equipped to handle. It has an integrated traffic control system, a surveillance system, of course the ventilation system, broadcast systems, firefighting systems, SOS boxes at every 150 meters to be used. It has world-class security systems. It's expected to boost tourism and economic activities in the state of Jammu and Kashmir. It connects two points, that's the Chenani in the Udhampur district of Jammu and Kashmir, to Nashari on the Ramban in the Ramban district of Jammu and Kashmir, reducing the travel time by over 2 hours. Earlier, this distance of 41 kilometers used to take about 2.5 hours of travel. Now it's reduced to just 9.2 kilometers, and the travel time reduced to about 12 to 15 minutes to cross this tunnel, which can the vehicles are allowed to move at a maximum speed of 50 kilometers per hour inside the tunnel. So we can see the Prime Minister going back to the Chenani side of the tunnel after actually reviewing the various provisions of the tunnel. It's expected to save about 27 lakh rupees of fuel at the current traffic estimates. Not just cutting the distance, not just cutting travel time, providing convenience, but also integrating the region of Jammu with the region of Kashmir, actually bringing the two capitals of the state, that's Jammu and Srinagar, both literally and figuratively closer. So the Prime Minister, along with the Governor, the Chief Minister, Union Ministers from his cabinet, reviewing the Chenani-Nashri Tunnel. built at a cost of over 2,500 crore rupees. It's an all-weather tunnel. It's equipped, as I said, with world-class safety features and has been built in a record 4 years on this hilly terrain of Jammu and Kashmir. And that is quite an achievement in terms of an engineering marvel. So we can see the Prime Minister right now, his cavalcade heading towards Chenani from where he entered this tunnel. More than 19 kilometers of excavation, of tunneling in completed in less than 4 years, which is a record time anywhere in the world. The tunnel is the first tunnel in India to be equipped with world-class fully integrated tunnel control system, through which ventilation, fire control, signals, communications, electrical systems, toll management are automatically actuated. That essentially means that the scope of human error by reducing human intervention has been greatly reduced. As I was saying, it cuts down the distance between Jammu and Srinagar. The people of the state, of course, would benefit by the amount of trade that it would generate. More trucks, more trade would flow through between these two regions. More trade means more economic activity. Tourism would be boosted, more employment opportunities. So clearly, the state of Jammu and Kashmir will be, this is another step towards bringing in more development and economic activity in the state of Jammu and Kashmir, creating employment opportunities. During the construction of this tunnel, a record 20,000 local workers were engaged by the construction company that constructed 2,000 skilled, semi-skilled and skilled youth of Jammu and Kashmir, that's local youth, were employed by the company for construction of this tunnel. The project director yesterday was telling me that for the maintenance, say for toll maintenance, toll management, they would be recruiting local youths. So it's provided employment opportunities for people. Of course, you know, the muck that has been dug out from the during the construction of this tunnel has been used to build a playground, a huge playground for a Kendriya Vidyalaya of the Chenani village, which did not have a playground. And in fact, today where the Prime Minister's choppers landed, it was made a makeshift helipad. I personally went and saw that playground. It is a huge playground which has benefited the students of Chenani village, who to have a playground in a school in a hilly terrain is generally a luxury. But that muck was used to fill in the deep gorges, and the area was leveled off. And there was no ecological disaster, harm done to the area. No deforestation was done. It was just blasting the mountain from under. In fact, houses on the upper reaches are still intact. The forest is still intact. So this tunnel, in that sense, the construction of this tunnel has not done any ecological harm to the area or to the region. हम देख सकते हैं कि प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी का काफिला चेनानी नाशरी टनल का मुआयना करने के बाद चेनानी की तरफ बढ़ता हुआ 9.2 किलोमीटर लंबी ये बाईडायरेक्शनल टनल है, जिसका मतलब है कि एक जम्मू बाउंड ट्रैफिक एक ओर से आएगा, एक लेन में श्रीनगर बाउंड ट्रैफिक जाएगा. ये टनल चेनानी और नाशरी का जो रास्ता है उसको 30 किलोमीटर से कम कर रही है, जिसका एसेंशियली मतलब ये है ट्रैवल टाइम में कि कम से कम 2-2.5 घंटे का रास्ता अगर ट्रैफिक स्मूथली चलता जाए तो वो कम कर रही है, क्योंकि अब केवल 12 से 15 मिनट लगेंगे एक सुरंग के एक छोर से निकलकर दूसरे छोर तक जाने को, और पूरा जो पहले पहाड़ घूमकर ये रास्ता जाना पड़ता था वो रास्ता टाइम फिजिकल डिस्टेंस और ट्रैवल टाइम कट होगा, और क्योंकि ये एरिया बड़ा लैंडस्लाइड प्रोन एरिया है और बड़ी क्योंकि शार्प बेंड्स हैं इस एरिया पे, हेयरपिन बेंड्स हैं, तो उसमें हमने देखा था कि बड़े जो व्हीकल्स होते थे ट्रक्स वगैरह अक्सर पलट जाया करते थे या ख़राब हो जाया करते थे, तो उसके चलते बड़े लंबे लंबे ट्रैफिक जैम्स लगा करते थे। तो अब उस सब को आराम से बाईपास किया जा सकता है क्योंकि ये एक ऑल वेदर टनल है, जिसका मतलब ये साल में पूरे हर वक्त एक्टिवेटेड रहेगी और किसी भी मौसम के दौरान ट्रैफिक में कोई बाधा नहीं होगी, तो ट्रैफिक स्मूथली फ्लो कर पाएगा। दूसरा, क्योंकि यहाँ तमाम वर्ल्ड क्लास ट्रैफिक मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम्स लगाए गए हैं ताकि जैम्स ना हों, कोलिजन्स ना हों, अगर कोई ब्रेकडाउन होता है या अगर कोई फायर जैसी या आग जैसी दुर्घटना होती है तो उसको तुरंत कैसे काबू पाया जाए और ट्रैफिक को लगातार चलने दिया जाए, उन सिस्टम्स के चलते ट्रैफिक स्मूथली मूव करेगा, चाहे वो LMV हों, चाहे वो लाइट मोटर व्हीकल्स हों, छोटी गाड़ियां हों या बड़े ट्रक हों। एक तो सुविधा होगी, वक्त बचेगा, ट्रेड इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटी बूस्ट होगी, पर्यटन बढ़ेगा, तमाम फायदे इस टनल के, जो अपने आप में एक इंजीनियरिंग मार्वल है जिसको प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी आज यहाँ इनॉग्रेट करने आए हैं। So we can see the Prime Minister traveling inside the tunnel. He's traveled the whole hog. He's gone the whole length right up. He entered from the Chenani side, went right up to the Nashri side, and now on his way back. Overall, through the journey, he reviewed the various. He got down from his vehicle, stopped his vehicle, reviewed the various measures. Systems there. Went out to the escape tunnel, walked into the escape tunnel, saw it for himself. The technical management team explaining to him the various features, and now the Prime Minister is on his way back to the Chenani side. This tunnel, which is ensured preservation of the forest in the ecologically sensitive Patni Top area, has wood. Proved to be a milestone in providing better integration of Jammu, not only with the people of the Kashmir Valley, but also with the regions with Kishtwar, Doda, Bhadarwaya, providing better connectivity and of course reduced travel time and safe travel. So we can see the Prime Minister right now reaching the Chenani end after going through the tunnel. The Prime Minister had entered the tunnel from the Chenani side and gone right up to the Nashri side and reviewed the whole tunnel. The Prime Minister now, along with the Governor and the Chief Minister of Jammu and Kashmir, coming out of the tunnel after reviewing the tunnel and seeing the various features and systems put in place in the tunnel. Prime Minister is now moving to the compound in which he would see an exhibition put up by the company for the construction company for the Prime Minister. All right, the Prime Minister once again with the various engineers of this company which constructed this state-of-the-art tunnel. The Prime Minister posing for a photograph with the employees of the companies. These are people who actually brought this dream, made this dream into reality in a time frame of just about 4 years, which is a record in itself, and of course it's an engineering marvel to cut the tunnel for to cut a mountain for 19 long kilometers and provide a tunnel in such a short span of time. the Prime Minister waving at the people, at the actual workforce behind this tunnel. After inaugurating the tunnel and dedicating it to the nation, the Prime Minister heading back from the Chenani-Nashri Tunnel. Now the Prime Minister from here will go down to Udhampur, where he shall be addressing a public rally. After dedicating and to the nation this tunnel, he shall be speaking to the people of Jammu and Kashmir. I'm sure he has a message to deliver. We shall be beaming that rally live to you in a little while, because the Prime Minister will now be taking off from Chenani, which is about which is a little distance from Udhampur, and he'll be landing in Udhampur, where he shall be addressing the people of Jammu and Kashmir. And I'm sure it's expected that he'll be talking about the various benefits that this tunnel would bring to the state, and the vision that the Modi government has for the development of the state of Jammu and Kashmir, and integrating it completely in terms of economic, social, political and emotional, emotionally with the rest of India. So the Prime Minister now leaving Chenani after inaugurating the Chenani.